is harder than carving a real pumpkin.
What do you think?
Scary.
Here, you guys cover this. Now I'll carve the next one. I'm just going to put a little bit of texture in the pumpkin. While I'm doing the faces, Ralph is sculpting the Headless Horseman topper.
The great Jack Lennon blazes near Sleepy Hollow, where Washington Irving's Headless Horseman story takes place. As a topper, a guy who has a jack-o'-lantern for a head just seemed like the right way to go.
One, two, and three.
Danny got me the airbrush. Give me a clear light. Since the cake is gonna be delivered outside at night, I wanted to add some lights in it to give it a glow so that it's gonna look just like a jack-o'-lantern.
It's missing something. You just gonna do leaves on the bottom?
I don't know. It's like it's bland.
We could get a pasta machine to make some hay.
Hay would be good.
Let's do it.
The cake was looking a little sparse and we needed to add some more like fall-themed elements to it. So we put the stack of jack-o'-lanterns on kind of a bed of hay at the bottom.
Doesn't look like hay. It's like pumpkin linguine. Let's throw some meatballs on there.
Everybody thinks my hay looks like pasta.
I made a bowl of pasta, and these pumpkins grew out of it.
It'll look more better when there's leaves.
It'll look more fall. The hope is, once we add the leaves, this will look like three pumpkins sitting on a pile of spaghetti.
Actually, that helps a lot.
It looks significantly better with the leaves.
I love it. I think that looks great. All right, what do you guys think, huh?
That's cool.
I think the way we carve the cake and then add the modeling chocolate, they look like pumpkins.
My favorite part is the leaves between the tiers. I think that really breaks up that orange a little, makes it pop.
Somebody shut the lights.
Let me see it with the lights off. Wow.
Spooky almost.
It feels like Halloween, man.
This is gonna be a fun delivery. I think everyone's gonna really like it.
That's how you make a pumpkin cake.